Hello, this is Eric Chappell, Civil Community Evangelist for Autodesk, here to talk to you today about what's new in InfraWorks Release 2018.2. During this presentation, you'll learn about better tools to extract features from point clouds, better ways to calculate quantities, better tools to design bridges to your needs, and finally, a totally new way to design roads. Let's start by looking at improvements to point cloud feature extraction tools in this latest release. With the latest release, InfraWorks will now analyze a point cloud more accurately as it automatically places vertices where it detects the top and bottom of a curb in cross-section view. This improved precision means that you'll spend less time manually adjusting curb break lines and that you'll get more accurate results from the software. Why is this important? It means that you can extract survey info from your point cloud data more efficiently than ever before. In the latest release of InfraWorks, you are now given two options when you match the endpoints of two extracted linear features. You can choose Connect to make the ends meet but keep the features separate, or you can choose Merge to convert the two features into one, similar to the PEdit command in AutoCAD with the Join option. With this option, the second feature will take on the properties of the first and become part of it. Why are these two new capabilities important? They allow you to extract survey info from point cloud data more effectively. In the latest release of InfraWorks, you can incorporate photographs into the point cloud data that you've included in your model. You can quickly call up these photographs based on locations in the model to assist you with identifying features that may be tricky to make out in the point cloud data. Why is this important? It allows you to convert point cloud data to model information more accurately and effectively. Now let's look at improvements to help you calculate volumes more effectively with InfraWorks. In the latest release of InfraWorks, visual cues show you which regions you're quantifying when you limit an area of interest by station. Also, generic pipes are now included in quantity calculations in addition to drainage pipes, which have been included in prior versions. You can also break down pipe quantities by depth range, giving you more granularity when performing pipe installation cost estimates. And finally, road components now have editable depth, which means that you can calculate more accurate quantities based on what's required for your design. Why is this all important? It means that you can compute quantities for road projects more efficiently and accurately than ever before. Next, we'll learn about better ways to design bridges so that you can meet your specific design requirements. In the latest release of InfraWorks, you'll find improvements to the workflow for incorporating custom parts into your bridges. For example, when defining a new parametric model, the Model Details tab will show you if you've provided the required parameters for the model to work. Also, the Part Sizes tab has a new easy-to-read layout. And finally, you can now import and export the information on the Part Size and UI Appearance tabs, making it easier to configure parts in other models. Why are these changes important? They make it easier than ever to incorporate custom parametric components into your bridges. In the latest release of InfraWorks, piers and abutments will adjust their widths automatically to respond to variations in road width. Also, bridges will not be created automatically when roads are created over water. The thinking here is that the designer should decide whether a bridge is to be placed versus a culvert or some other crossing design. Why are these changes important? They allow you to more efficiently incorporate bridges into your designs. And finally, probably the biggest news in this release, a new approach to road design and layout. In the latest release of InfraWorks, you'll find an entirely new way to design roads, element-based layout. With this new approach, you can create any combination of tangents and curves, including compound and reverse curves. Simply right-click to choose between tangents and curves as you draw. There's even a three-point curve option for more accuracy and control. Also, you now have the full flexibility to begin or end a road with a curve. You'll find this way of designing much more effective than the previous PI-based approach, but that approach is still available if you choose to use it. Why is this new approach so important? It allows you to design roads with increased efficiency and accuracy. With the latest release of InfraWorks, you'll find a more streamlined user interface for road design. First, when you begin your design, you'll find what you need neatly arranged in the stack on the right, including the assembly, design standards, and design speed. The newly designed messages at the bottom of the screen are more effective at sharing tips and warnings. You can now hold the Shift key to move a vertex along an established line or curve in the road alignment. Newly designed dimensions are easier to read and in some cases can be edited to control geometry in the model. You can now edit the depth of lanes and other road components to more accurately model the design and calculate quantities. And finally, the default slope configuration for new roads is fixed slope instead of fixed width. Why are all these improvements important? They allow you to design roads more accurately and more efficiently. After seeing the improvements that have been made in this latest release, I'm sure you're wondering how you can download and install it right away. All you have to do is check your Autodesk desktop application or visit manage.autodesk.com and look for the update. If you're not currently an InfraWorks customer, simply visit autodesk.com/infraworks and download the free 30-day trial. Thanks for allowing me to tell you about the exciting new features in InfraWorks Release 2018.2. Have a great day.